Hi there. The power over Ethernet, aka the PoE, allows us to use a single Ethernet cable to send both power and data through a Cat5e or a Cat6 UTP cable. Now, it's pretty handy to set up a low voltage device such as the IP cameras, the access point, the VoIP phone, or Internet of Things, the IoT equipment. So today in this video, I'm going to talk about what kind of equipment has a PoE built in. Now, before we jump to the video, make sure you hit the like button because it really helps our YouTube algorithm and make my life a whole lot easier. So let's get right into it. So the most common device is the PoE injector. Basically, a PoE injector power supply unit, and it can combine data from a network switch or router with a DC power and send it over to the UTP cable. Now, this is the typical PoE injector. As you can see, we have the data port to link to the main network to get data. Besides, we have the PoE port. This port is to link to the edge device. Over here, we have the AC power input port. And don't worry, because the AC power will convert into a low voltage DC power, typically like a DC 54 volt. So here are some different forms of the PoE injector. This one is called the IP67 outdoor waterproof version. As you can see, this is completely waterproof. And for high power, we have the 90 volt high power PoE injector. And for fast speed and high power, we have, this is heavy, the 10 gigabyte high power PoE injector. So the second type is the PoE switch. The PoE switch is widely deployed in the field, and it looks no different from a regular switch. Only the PoE power is integrated into the switch. Now, those ports not only provide the data exchange, but also the PoE as well. And we can consider the PoE injectors are built into the switch. Now, they just turn into a PoE switch. So we all know there's power over UTP cable in the PoE system, but is it safe to use PoE? The standard PoE has power handshaking. That means before the PoE injector or the PoE switch releases the power to the edge, it will first have to verify and classify the edge device. If the edge device doesn't support PoE, that means the injector or the switch will not send the power at all. Now, our next device is the PoE splitter. If you want to connect a non-PoE device to a PoE injector or a PoE switch, you can't get any power. In this case, you need to add the PoE splitter at the other end of the cable, because the PoE splitter will complete the power handshaking with the PoE injector and the PoE switch. And in the meanwhile, it will separate the power from the data, so we can supply the non-PoE device. So the PoE network is limited to only 328 feet. So if the distance between two devices is beyond 328 feet, you need to use the PoE extender. The PoE extender will repeat the PoE network for another 328 feet. So adding one extender will allow you to have totally up to 650 feet. But one thing people might misunderstand is the PoE extender never repeats the power. It can only repeat the data. So you might need to consider the power loss in some application. So we have one more special device called the PoE power switch, aka the PoE pass-through switch. This switch can not only be powered by another PoE switch and pass through the PoE power to the edge device. And this is also a pretty handy tool to reuse the existing cable to expand your PoE network. Now, if you want to know anything about the PoE power switch, you can watch another video about it. So thank you for watching. I will see you next time.